and ask that the blood of the Lamb cleanse away your sin. Let your blood cleanse me from the crown of my head to the sole of my feet. Satan, listen to me. I'm not afraid to mention this name. After the resurrection of Christ, a name above every other name has been given unto him. And at the mention of his name, every knee shall bow. Satan, bow down at the name of Jesus. This is the victory that overcome the world. 1 John chapter 5 verse 4 says, I overcome Satan by the blood of Jesus. By my faith in Christ, he who died and resurrected, I overcome Satan. I overcome the work of flesh. I overcome satanic onslaught. I overcome every satanic power. I am an overcomer by the blood of Jesus. I am saved. I am saved. I am lifted up. I'm sitting at the high places with Christ. I am lifted up. Christ is under my feet. I have been set free. I am freed indeed. Set free from poverty, from addiction, from rejection. I am set free from loneliness. I am set free from lack and poverty, stagnation. I have been set free. I am free indeed. I am free. I don't know about you. I am free. I am free. Christ is in me, the hope of glory. I am free. I am free. My children have been set free, and they are free indeed. My wife has been set free, and she's free indeed. In the name of Jesus, I am free. Salvation is a gift of God, not a work of man. It's a precious gift from our Maker. I receive the gift of salvation. I am saved. Ephesians 2:8-9. I am saved by his grace. His blood has set me free, and I'm free indeed. His blood has set you free, and you are free indeed. In the name of Jesus, you are set free. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Holy Spirit of God. We give you praise, we give you glory. Blessed be to your name. Glory be to your name. In Jesus' name we pray. Let's put those hands together, brother Sam, come over. Hold those hands together for Jesus Christ of Nazareth. You are set free and you are free indeed in Jesus' name. You confess it, you profess it, and so shall it be, that the name of the Lord will be glorified in your life. Put those hands together for Jesus Christ of Nazareth.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God bless you. May you have your majestic seat. In the name of Jesus. Shall we have a word of prayer? In the name of Jesus, we thank you, O God. We give you praise. We give you adoration for your grace and your mercies, for your love, kindness, for your protection, for everything that you have done in our lives, O God, for the salvation, O God, that you have given to us for free, that we pay nothing for the air that we breathe in, O God. We deserve not to have been living by now, but by your grace we are here. Not because of our good works, but it's just because you paid the price. We thank you. We bless your name. We exalt you, O God. In the name of Jesus, I pray and I soak myself in your hands, O God. I want to be a vessel that you will use, O God. I pray and commit everybody in your hands. May you soften any hardened heart, O God, and pulverize it. And let your word have a place that it may be germinated and give birth to fruit in the name of Jesus. Thank you, O God, in the name of Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. God bless you all for making it tonight. It's just by his grace that we are all alive. And not everybody have got that permission and that grace to be in the presence of God. Many desire to be in the presence of God. But I bless God for your life that you are here. In the name of Jesus. So we want to talk about salvation. But I always ask myself a question, and I want to ask you. Have you ever asked yourself, What is the mission of the church? I'm not talking about RPPT. What's the mission of the church? Why are we coming to church? Have that question ever come to your mind? Why do you come to church? Do you come to church that God will heal your sickness? Or you come to church that God will show himself a miracle in your life? Or because you need favor from God, but because you're applying for a job that you need favor from, or you need somebody to pray for you, that is why you come to church? Or if you have a reason for coming to church, but it's one reason why we all gather here. And that is what I want to show you tonight. I always ask myself, the mission of the church is missions. It's very short. The mission of the church is missions. You were once out there. I was once out there. Somebody had to minister to me before I became born again. And when you become a born again Christian, you don't stay with the grace. You don't stay with the salvation that you have gotten. But you have to also reach out to other people. That's the missions. That is salvation. You have salvation. You have to give salvation. It is not you that will win the soul, but it is the Holy Spirit. But he needs you to go out there and say, God loves you. John 3:16, we all know, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whoever believes in him will not perish but have everlasting life. God loves us all. Even in our iniquities, he came to die for our sins. He was there in the beginning, incarnately, but he came in to birth because the earth was given to man to take dominion over. So he has to come in as through the womb of a woman. So he came in to save us from our iniquity, to save us from our sins. And that's where we have salvation. So how do we reach out to other people? Is it by going out and saying to other people, God loves you? There are a lot of ways that we can minister to people. Our lifestyle. Missions is a lifestyle. How do you relate with people in your workplace? How do you relate with people in your neighborhood? The people, even the people in the church, how do you relate with them? That is what we want to talk about tonight. So I want you to open your Bibles to Philippians 2:12. I want you to know that before we can accomplish the mission of the church, we ourselves have to be saved. We ourselves have to have that salvation. We have to lead a life that is worthy of ministering to other people. As I said earlier on, missions is a lifestyle. It's not your words. It's not how eloquent you are, how knowledgeable, how many scriptures you have memorized, and how you can explain yourself better. Or your education level, your master's degree or your bachelor's degree or your doctorate degree that you have. That is not what ministry or the missions is about. Mission is about living a lifestyle. You say you believe in Jesus Christ and you want to follow him. You have to follow his lifestyle. That is why when the first people who were called Christians, they were given the name Christian because they led the life of Christ. And the people saw them doing the same thing Christ came and did. And they said, these people are Christ-like. Can somebody tell you are a Christ-like person in your workplace? Can somebody tell you are a Christ-like person in school? Can somebody tell you are a Christ-like person in wherever you find yourself? It's time for us to judge ourselves, to look through our life and see what we do. Does it merit what we are or what we call ourselves, the name we have tagged ourselves to be? Christians, do we live the life of Christ? The Bible says that we have been given salvation for free. We have been given, somebody wept for that salvation. Somebody died for it, used his blood for that salvation. What are you doing in return? That is the question. What are you doing in return? Are you just coming to church and go back home? And come to church and go back home?
How does your life affect others that are around you? Does it affect them negatively or positively? Let's look through our life. Let's look through our life every day. Let's examine ourselves. The Bible says that all scriptures are good. And it's good for correction to the perfection of the man of God. Not only people who preach. You are a man of God. You are a woman of God. It doesn't matter where you find yourself. Whether an usher, a church cleaner, you are a minister of God. Whatever you do. Yesterday, I was in the library, in my school's library, studying. And the woman cleaning was ministering. And I was like, "What? You were just a cleaner. Will you allow us to study?" I didn't tell her. She was like, "God bless you. God bless you. You are a doctor in Jesus' name. You are an accountant in Amen. Then I was like, "Oh, this is just a cleaner. And she is seriously ministering." I was so marveled. I was like, "So what am I doing?" How many people have you spoken to about Christ? Or how many people have your life spoken to about Christ? The Bible says in Philippians 2:12 that you work your own salvation with fear and trembling. Work your own salvation. That's what Paul said. Work your own salvation with fear and trembling. How do you work your own salvation? Salvation has been given to you. In heavens, they have all kinds of records, all kinds of books. Books of records. We have books of reward, books of all kinds of books. Your name can appear in books of reward because you have done all good to people. But have you done the will of God? Have you been able to be a missionary? Have you ministered to people about Christ? You have been taught a lot to be a teacher. We have grown from drinking milk. You have to chew bones. You've been given milk. Oh, people have been preaching about grace. Oh, God doesn't care about what you do. You can do whatever you want to do, and God doesn't care. That God doesn't look at what you do. Really? God doesn't look? Grace, the Paul said, should we continue in sin that grace may abound? Certainly not. We can't continue doing what is not right. We know within ourselves that backbiting is not good. Lying and false witness and all kinds of sin is not good. But we do them because we have been brainwashed that grace will abound. We are under grace. And I have friends that are learned and have their bachelors and masters, and they tell me, "Oh, the Old Testament is made away." But we go back to the Old Testament and take the blessings of the Old Testament. We don't want to follow the commandment in the Old Testament, but we want to claim the blessings. Yes, that's what we do. We want to claim the blessings. We are human beings. We are too smart. Claim the blessings and leave the rest. Because the Old Testament has been made away. But I tell you, in Philippians is a New Testament. Paul wrote that. And he said, "Work your own salvation with fear and trembling." That is a New Testament. I didn't quote from the Old Testament. So salvation it entails a lot. There's a lot to it than just coming to church. There's a lot to it than just being in a choir. There's a lot to it than just playing the instrument. There's a lot to it than just being a member. How long will you be a church member? Then how long will you just come and sing songs and go home? How long will you clean the church and go home? How long? In the book of Acts, when the disciples met in the upper room, they prayed. That was the first thing they did. They prayed, and when the Holy Spirit came upon them, they went out to minister the word of God. They didn't sit with the Holy Spirit. You have too much Holy Spirit in you. Too much Holy Spirit in you. And you're sitting on it. Go out there. When they went out there to minister their first soul winning was 3,000 souls. The Holy Spirit is in you. It's been dormant in you. How long will the Holy Spirit be dormant in you? How can't you just open your mouth and say God loves you to somebody? Even in your workplace, just like the woman was doing in the library, telling everybody, God loves you. You are a doctor in Jesus' name. You've passed your exams in Jesus' name. It's not a joke. She might just saying it. She's ministering. She's ministering. We can minister anywhere we will. It's not about telling somebody, God bless you and God loves you. Let your light so shine before men that they may see the good works and give glory unto your Father who is in heaven. Matthew 5:16. That is the scriptures my mom always raised, and that scriptures is always in my mind. My mom is an illiterate. She doesn't know how to read. I don't know how she learned that scripture. I don't know how she got that scripture. And she can quote it and say it all throughout. Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and give glory unto your Father who is in heaven. How many people can give glory to your Father in heaven because of your life? How many people can give glory to your Father because of how you led your life? Where you, the footsteps that you left. Can somebody say, oh, I want to walk through these footsteps. I want to be like this person. Yes, we have salvation, but we have to work. We believe in Jesus Christ. The Bible says when the Pharisees were asking Jesus, how do we work the works of God? Jesus answered and said, by believing in him that he has sent. You believe in him he has sent. How do you believe in him that he has sent and do things that he doesn't want you to do? You can't believe in me, and if I'm doing something, you don't believe in my vision, then you don't believe in me. You don't do what I do. And you don't do what I want you to do. You don't believe in me. We have different agendas. Now, we have learned so much that, as the Bible said, that the time will come when we'll be learning so much that our knowledge will make us fools. Now, because of grace, everybody does whatever they want. We dress anyhow we want to church. Yes, because you can dress it. What is the difference between somebody who is not saved and you that is saved? What's the difference between your dressings? If you said you are saved and you want your life to shine, that he or she will see that there is something unique in you, the first thing the person will look at is your dressing, the way you dress and the way you talk. That's the first thing the person will look at. This person say he is a Christian. Is he really a Christian? Does he talk like a Christian? Does he do his things like this? People are watching you. I tell you, they might seem not looking at you, but they are really watching you. When the time comes for them to ask you questions, you know that they have been watching you for years. People are looking at you. People are looking at you to follow your lifestyle. What kind of lifestyle are you leading in your workplaces? You have sat on your salvation. You don't want anybody else to have that salvation because you got it for free. You didn't pay the price for it. But now Paul is telling us that we should work out our own salvation with fear and trembling, because there is nothing that God have done for us. He has given us the salvation to come into his presence, but we have to work it as we grow. We have to grow. We can't be children all throughout. We have to grow. We were born as toddlers and we grew to be adult and old men and older. We were drinking milk when we were young. We started eating meat and we start chewing bones. The Bible says, as Pastor said, lack of knowledge, my people perish. And he said, study to show yourself a proof of God. A workman who is not ashamed and can divide the word of God. God help us. Sometimes I look at church members and I get so frustrated. We go to work on time, but we come to church whenever we want to. Because we are not clocking in, and nobody is looking at when and what time we leave. But God is watching. I tell you, God is watching. We dress anyhow. We dress just like we're going to a club. If dressing had no, dressing don't have a, wherever place you go don't have a dress code, then I can wear a suit and go to the basketball field and start playing basketball. Can I dress like this to the basketball court? Can I dress like this and go to the football court? No. Everywhere you go has a dress code. So the club has their dress code. Leave them. And you, the church, has your dress code. You can't dress and you're half naked. And you have to carry cloth and cover yourself when you sit down because you know you'll be showing certain things that are not to be. So why not cover yourself before you come? God have mercy. God help us. And the Bible says in 2 Timothy 3:15 to 17, and that from the child that has known the holy scriptures, which are able to make thee wise unto salvation through the faith of Jesus Christ. All scriptures are given for inspiration of God and in profitable for doctrine, for proof, for correction, for instruction unto righteousness, that the man of God may be perfect through furnished unto good works. So we know the scriptures. Who doesn't have? It was then before that we didn't have Bible to ourselves. Now Bible is everywhere on the internet, everywhere. You can read scriptures in your car, in the workplace, wherever you find yourself. You have access to the Bible. Why are we living our life recklessly? Because salvation has been given to us for free? Because grace will abound? But because we are under grace, Jesus Christ has died for our sins? So we should continue in doing the sins? Paul said, certainly not. So we are not going to control in that. In the name of Jesus. This is the last days that the Bible have prophesied. You can see all the signs and all the signs that the Bible have said are showing up. When you read the book of 2 Timothy 3, 1 to the 5 verses, it says, this also that in the last days, perilous times shall come. For men shall be lovers of their own selves, covetous, boasters, proud, blasphemous, disobedient to parents, unthankful, unholy, without natural affection, trust breakers, false accusers, incontinent, feast, despisers of those that are good, traitors, heavy heart, high-minded, lovers of pleasure, more than love of God. Ever learned, the seventh verse, ever learned and reverable to become to come to the knowledge of it. We are always learning, but we're not finding the truth. This is the last days that the Bible said the nations shall rise against nations. Don't you hear those? This is the time for us to examine ourselves and find what we are not doing right. Jesus can come tonight. And when he's coming, as Pastor said, he's not coming as a lamb anymore. He's coming as a lion. He's coming as a lion. So many will say, I use your name in preaching and in healing and deliverance. So he will tell them, you workers of iniquities. Are you going to be part of the folks that are going, or you're going to? It's either you are in or you are out. You can't be, there's no in between. It's either you are holy or you are unholy. There's no in between. So know what you stand for. I always get agitated when I hear others stand for what they believe in. And they are proud and bold to speak about it. And Christians are quiet. Somebody tell I'm atheist, I don't believe in anything. And he can explain, he can give you the facts and everything. But Christians, the moment we are always hiding. Because we are not learning the Bible. We are not applying the scriptures to our life. We are trying to hide from what the Bible wants us to do by covering ourselves with the grace of God. And trying to leave the Old Testament and come to the New Testament. But the more you leave the Old Testament and come to the New Testament, scriptures are there in the New Testament that Paul is also emphasizing. We all go through that. We all fall short. Nobody is perfect. But we live every day that we may be perfect. Paul said, I do the things that I don't want to do. Not because I want to do them, but it's just because the sinful nature in me. Oh, wretched man, who can save me? Look, we all have shortfall. That's what the Bible says. In our weakness, he has been made strong. And he said, pray that you may not go into temptations, because God knows that there is a lot of temptation on earth. Jesus experienced it when he came to this earth. He fasted for 40 days. And when he finished, Satan came to him and said, yes, if you are the Son of God, turn these stones to bread. You are hungry. And eat. And Jesus said, man shall not live by bread alone, but every word that proceeds from them. Jesus. And he did not give up. If Satan don't give up on Jesus, who is the Son of God, you think Satan is going to give up on you? Oh, Jesus. He's not going to give up on you. He did not give. He took him to the mountains and showed him all the world, everything, the treasures. I said, if you bow down before me, I'll give you all this that you see. Oh, Jesus. But he forget that keys have been taken from him already. He didn't own the world before. But when Jesus came to die, he didn't want Jesus to go through the process of dying to get the keys from him. So he was just trying to offer him. But God didn't want to go through that easy route. And he took him on another way to the church door and said, throw yourself onto the floor. And Satan quoted scripture. He said, and he will send for his angel to catch you, that your legs shall not touch the stones. Even Satan knows scriptures. It's not how much scriptures you know makes you a Christian. It's not how good you sing or how good you play instrument. How many people have you taught how to play instruments since you started playing? How many people have you lectured since you became a Christian? How many people are following you? How many people are your children or your spiritual children? How many people are you discipled? How many people have you taught how to sing? How many songs do you know? You call yourself a musician. How many songs do you know? You call yourself a Christian. How many scriptures do you know? How can you defend yourself? How good can you defend your faith when you are called upon? One time I met a Muslim. At my workplace, he wanted to go in argument with me. And I asked him a simple question. Why are you a Muslim? And he told me his parents are Muslim. I was like, that's not a good answer. So I'm sorry, I'm not talking to you. You don't even know your scriptures. If your parents are Muslim, that's why you are Muslim. Then you don't have a vision. You don't know what you are for. Everybody for himself. Nobody's salvation can take somebody else. Your wife's salvation cannot pick you up. Your father's salvation cannot pick you up. That's why he said, work your own salvation with fear and trembling. So salvation is individual work. Sometimes I wonder why people don't want to learn scriptures. Don't want to live a life that is Christ-like. God help us. In Jesus' name. I want us to pray tonight. When you read the book of Luke 19 that we read, somebody was eager to know Christ. Somebody was eager to know who he is, how he looks. Well, he has heard of Christ, and he has heard and heard of Christ, and now he wants to know him. He was a sinner. Somebody who doesn't know Christ wants to know Christ. And you know Christ already, and you are playing around because you think you have learned scripture so much that you know that grace is where we are now, so you can do whatever you want. Somebody was ready to give up all he had. Zacchaeus, he was ready to give up all he had for salvation. What have you given out for salvation? You didn't pay a price for salvation, and you don't want to work it out yourself. He gave all he had, and he said, if I have wrongly taxed somebody outrageously, I give the person 7 times back. That's how agent salvation was to him. I want us to look through our lives. We come to church, we want to be paid for everything we do in church. Oh Jesus. Because of small singing you sing, you want to be paid. Small singing, and God gave you the voice to sing, you want to be paid for it. It's because of small drums you play in the church, you want to be paid. God help us. What did you do for your salvation? What are you doing for Christ? Is it just putting on nice clothes and coming to church every Sunday that makes you a Christian? No. Christianity is a lifestyle. That's the lifestyle. That's the emission of the lifestyle that disciple led that gave them that name. And you are enjoying that name without working and living that lifestyle. So you can't enjoy that name without living the lifestyle. You can't be called a Christian when you're not living a Christ-like life. You can be among the congregation, but you're not a Christian. I want us to look through our lives. And this is the day of salvation. This is the day of salvation. This is the day of missioning. We are preparing ourselves and look through our life, the things that we fall short, and ask God, this is what I fall short. He knows we are weak. And one musician said, thou, we are weak, thou art strong. Guide us, O Lord. God is strong. And he said, in our weakness, he has been made strong. We are not making use of the scriptures. We are not making use of the words in the Bible. The Bible says, my words are yea and amen. Go through the scriptures. Use the scripture. When you fall short, when you go and you went to lie, or you come back home, God, I lied. And now we feel comfortable sinning because we think grace is abound. So when we do it, we don't even see it as sin anymore. The moment you don't feel like what you did is wrong anymore, that is the way of backsliding. You are losing your salvation. You can lose your salvation if somebody didn't tell you that. You are going wayward. Now you sin and you see it normal. Oh, everybody is doing it. In America, we dress anyhow we want. You can just dress any way you want. You can put whatever you want on and go to church. Yes. Yes, you can do. But the Bible says, don't be the one that will be tempted, will make somebody fall. You're doing that for a brother to fall?
You are committing the sin. Let's check ourselves. These are simple things that we can put away with. We can do away with. How we talk to others, how we dress, how we do things. You don't have to do too much. Salvation, you don't have to do too much. Just the way you conduct yourself, the way you talk to others, the way you control yourself. All these are the fruit of the Spirit.
Patient, meekness, all these are fruit of the Spirit. It's not difficult. The Holy Spirit will lead us through.
I want us to pray tonight and come to God with everything that we have done. Maybe you have done something you think, oh, now it is the fashion of the day. It's not the fashion of the Bible didn't say it's the you just go with the flow. We are not going with the flow. We are setting a standard. Christianity is about setting a standard. Let the people know that this is how it goes. Yes, when she came, she was a prostitute and she came in. She would dress like a prostitute. But when she entered, let the person know that, yes, oh, this place, everybody dressed different. I think I should change my dressing. Let the person know that. Look around and see that she has to really change. He has to really change his dressing. Oh, I have to watch the way I talk. Everybody talk different here. But if they come in and they see us talk the way they talk on the street and they dress the way they dress on the street and in the club, how would they think of us as Christians? And we go to schools and we do things anyhow. They are watching you. And you call yourself a son of God, a Christian. And you talk anyhow, you dress anyhow. Let your life so shine before men that they may see your good works and give glory unto your Father in heaven. I want us to be on our feet tonight. I want you to go before God. It's not about telling somebody, tell God what you have done. He knows what you did. It's not a secret to him. It's not something you are hiding. Maybe you did something that you think, oh, it's just the fashion of the day. Everybody does it. It's normal. But you heard today, it's not normal. It's not normal to dress half naked. It's not normal to speak anyhow. It's not normal to conduct yourself anyhow in public. Let your light shine. Maybe your light, there's a light in you that you have not let it shine yet. Let it shine. It's a sin not letting the light in you shine. That is already a sin. Not doing the mission of the missions of the church is a sin. How many people have you ministered to? How many people have you talked to about Christ? How many people have you told God loves you? Just saying God loves you to somebody relieve the person from sin stress. Saying good morning to somebody is releasing somebody from a stress. I want you to pray. Commit yourself before God. Anything that you have done that is not right before God. You might not even know what you did, but not being in the will of God is a sin. Not inquiring from God for whatever you did, your plans and your visions, it's a sin. Because you've gone out of the will of God. In the name of Jesus. Father, have mercy upon us tonight, O God. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Many of the things that we have done wrong, that we have stepped away from your will, O God. We have not done the missions of the church, O God. We have come unto you today and we surrender, O God, all unto you. We declare, O God, that from today we shall minister unto the people that are lost, O God, in the name of Jesus. We pray, O God, that you will strengthen us in our weakness. Anything we fall short in, may you empower us, O God, that we be strong in it, O God, in the name of Jesus. Have your own way, O God. Have your own way. Have mercy upon us, in the name of Jesus. Have mercy upon us, O God, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus. When you read the book of 1 Timothy 2:8, he said, therefore I want the men in every place to pray, lifting up holy hands without anger and disputing. How holy are your hands? How holy are your hands? Sometimes we say we stand in the right place of God to pray. But there are certain principles. God is a just God, a principle God. I remember when he was giving the specification to Noah to build the ark. I wonder if God went to an engineering school. He gave specification like an engineer. So God is a principle God. He tells you what to do and you have to do the same thing. So we are praying tonight that God will wash us from any iniquities, anything that have made us filthy, that we cannot, that our prayers are not even heard anymore because of our sins. We are praying that God will forgive us our sins, anything consciously or unconsciously that we have done that we did not know. We are praying that the Lord himself will have mercy upon us, even as the church in the name of Jesus. If the church have stepped away from his will, we are praying tonight that the Lord will have mercy upon us in the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we come unto you, O God, and we ask, O God, that you will forgive us our iniquities, O God. Anything that we have done consciously or unconsciously, we are pleading, O God, tonight that you have your way, O God. May you forgive us our sins and have mercy upon us. We commit the church in your hands. Anything that we have done as a church, that whatever we have done that have stepped away from your will for the church, may we pray, oh God, tonight that you will have mercy upon the church tonight in the name of Jesus. We pray, oh God, that you have mercy upon us in the name of Jesus. May you have mercy, oh God, even as your word have said that if we commit our sins, you are faithful and just to forgive us and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. May you forgive us our sins tonight in the name of Jesus, and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Strengthen us in that weakness, oh God, that weakness that will take us to hell. May you strengthen us that we will be able to stand and be able to minister and do the will of your word in the name of Jesus. Have your own way, oh God. Have mercy upon us in the name of Jesus. Have mercy upon us in the name of Jesus. 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 We are going to pray with our prayer book. Everybody has their prayer book. We already prayed for the mercies of God. We're not going to claim, oh Lord, I claim my tree for an encounter with the in Jesus' name. Oh Lord, fetch me out of the multitude of people for your divine visitation in Jesus' name. We need the divine visitation of God. I want us to pray that God will fetch us out of the multitude and place us on divine visitation. God should visit us. As Pastor was talking, he said, God visited him. God showed himself unto him. When Paul was on his way to Damascus and when we're persecuting the people of the Christians, he had an encounter with God. And that changed everything of his life. It changed his name. He was Saul and now he is Paul. I want you to pray that God will have an encounter with you. God will have a divine visitation with you tonight and at the days of your life, that your destiny will change. Your name will change. If people saw you to be a bad person before, from today, your name from bad will be good in the name of Jesus. If you were a boring before, from today, you are fruitful in the name of Jesus. That is divine visitation. If you are dumb before, from today, you are smarter and you are intelligent, because the Bible says, if anyone lack wisdom, he should ask of him and he will give unto him. I want you to pray tonight, whatever whatever visitation you need from God, may he have an invite, divine visitation with you in the name of Jesus. If your mortal bodies are weak, if you need healings, if you need deliverance, may the Lord have divine visitation with you in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, open your mouth and pray. In the name of Jesus, we pray tonight for divine visitation, oh God. We need an encounter with you. In the name of Jesus, may you speak to us, oh God. May you change our name. May you change our destiny. In the name of Jesus, when we used to call us bad, may the name good come unto us, because excellence is of you. In the name of Jesus, may you give unto us excellence. In the name of Jesus, may we become fruitful. In the name of Jesus, may we become excellent, intellectually, oh God, active. In the name of Jesus, may you empower us, oh God, unto all good works. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, have your way, oh God, have your way, oh God, have your way. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Now we're going to pray that God will save us from the hands of the destroyer, our families and our loved ones from the hands of the destroyer. In the name of Jesus. The enemy comes and he works 24 hours without resting. You remember Satan, Lucifer was a chief musician in heavens. So he is very strong. You can't fight him yourself. But we with Jesus in us, we are stronger than everyone. The Bible says, by the mention of his name, all knee bow and tongues confess that he is God. And they know him because he is the Son of God. So I want you to pray tonight. We are not praying, you are not praying by your strength. You are praying in the name of Jesus. That if above all other name, we are praying tonight that the Lord will shield us from the devourer's claws. Any enchantment of the in the atmosphere, whatever incantation, whatever they mention our name, may tender strike wherever they meet and they mention our name, because they mention no other name but the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, Makada Rabosha, Levenda Rabosha, Revenda Rabosha. In the name of Jesus, if anybody is sick, may you, oh God, heal us, because your word said, by your stripes all diseases are healed. May you, oh God, shield us from the devourer's hands. In the name of Jesus, may the enemy not feed on our weakness. In the name of Jesus, any weakness of our life that, oh God, causes us to sin, that we not see your face, oh God, tonight we stand in the blood of Jesus, the blood that speaks better things than the blood of Abel. We declare that your strength to be our strength, and we have no strength of ours, for your word saying, in our weakness you have been made stronger. May you shield us from the devourer's hand, our loved ones, in the name of Jesus, our mother, our parents, the church, the pastor, in the name of Jesus. May you shield us, may you protect us, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, I want us to pray. Many are the things that we have done that have made us lose certain things that we were supposed to possess. Because of certain things that we did, we lost them. We are praying that the Lord will restore unto us anything that we have lost because of our reckless lives that we have led. Sometimes the will of God is not made manifest in our life because of the things where we shouldn't be, we were. And we lost the glory, we lost the blessing God wanted to bestow unto us. So we are praying that the Lord will restore unto us anything we have lost because of our sin. In the name of Jesus, open your mouth and pray. Mako venda da da bosha, le venda da 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 bosha pa, redenda da da bosha, madu shapa di anda bosha, le kavenda da da bosha pa. In the name of Jesus, may you restore unto us, O God, anything that we have lost, O God, because of our reckless life. In the name of Jesus, because of our sins. In the name of Jesus, because we have been disobedient. Because, oh God, we've been liars in the name of Jesus. Because we have committed adultery and we have committed fornications. Because of anything that we have done that is contrary to, oh God, what you have spurred us to do. That we have lost any blessing of ours. Tonight we stand in the blood of Jesus. The blood, oh God, that saves us. The blood that cleans us. In the name of Jesus, that you will restore unto us. In the name of Jesus. We are kneeling down before you, O God. We pray, O God, that you give unto us, O God, anything that we have lost, living a reckless life in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. If anything that you have given to the enemy wrongly because you did not know, you handed your destiny to the enemy without knowing because of something you did, something that you ate, something that you put yourself into. We are praying that God will have mercy upon us and bring up back anything that we have lost, anything that we have recklessly given to the enemy, any blessing of us that we have handed over to the enemy. For the Bible said that the death key is on his hand, and the Bible says he took it from the pit of hell. None, everything, every key for heavens and the earth is in the hands of the Lord. Therefore, we are not anymore captive to the enemy in the name of Jesus. And anything that is yours, you take it by force tonight in the name of Jesus. Nothing belongs to the enemy. The Bible says he is a thief and he come not. He only come to steal, kill and destroy. But the Lord came that we will have life more abundantly. In the name of Jesus, we pray tonight, oh God, anything that we have handed it over to the enemy without knowing, in the name of Jesus, may you, oh God, we claim it back in the name of Jesus. We take our blessing back in the name of Jesus. Tonight we stand in the blood of Jesus and we take everything back. We claim our blessing. We restore everything back in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. The seven, Almighty Father, restore back to me whatever I have lost ignorantly by household enemy in Jesus' name. Oh Lord, I plead the blood of Jesus Christ to recover my time, finance, wealth, success, breakthrough, fruitfulness, achievement, etc. that have been stolen by the enemy in Jesus' name. I told you that Bible says the enemy does not come. Only when he comes to steal because he doesn't have anything. He didn't create anything, so he doesn't have anything. He only steals what we have, that which we have been given by divine restoration, by divine power that we hand over to him. He didn't even have authority, but we hand over to him ignorantly. So we are praying tonight, anything the enemy has stolen from us because we led a bad life, because we have spoken wrongly in public, because we did something that is not right from God in the face of God, we are praying tonight. Today we have known that we will work our own salvation with fear and trembling, and we have known today that in our weakness you have been made strong. Therefore we are no more weak anymore, because if you are in us, is the hope of glory. And when we are glorious, the enemy cannot stand before us. Therefore, we claim back anything, our fruitfulness, our achievement, our breakthrough, our finances, our wealth, our health, in the name of Jesus, that we have recklessly handed over unto the enemy, in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus.
I want us to pray one last prayer. I remember when the disciples went into the upper room, the thing what they did was to pray until the Holy Spirit came upon them. We have the Holy Spirit. We pray for the activation of the Holy Spirit in us, that we'll be able to step out to minister His word like never before in the name of Jesus. That is what salvation is about. You have salvation, you give salvation, and you don't keep it to yourself. But we are praying for that enablement, empowerment to go out to minister the word of God unto other people, unto the lost soul, unto the needy of the word. In the name of Jesus, open your mouth and pray. And the Bible says, in the last days, I shall pour down my spirit upon all flesh. The prophetess and the prophet, the dreamers shall be in, and the visioners will be. And He has given all giftings, teaching, prophetic and all kinds of giftings. We pray, oh God, we tap into that giftings tonight, because You have made us whole tonight, that we have realized that we've sinned against Thee, and You have forgiven us. We request, oh God, that You give unto us the Spirit, the enablement, oh God, to quicken our immortal bodies to be able to step out to minister Your word with our lifestyle, even that the Bible says in Matthew 5:16, that let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and give glory unto the Lord. In the name of Jesus, we want to live a Christ-like life. We need Your strength. We need Your empowerment. In the name of Jesus. 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 Thank You, everlasting Father. In the name of Jesus. Father, we thank You, O God. We bless Your name, O King. We salute Your majesty tonight because You have spoken to us and we have heard You, O God. We pray, O God, that we are weak, Thou art strong. Guide us, O God. Strengthen us, even as Your word has said, that in our weakness You have been made strong, O God. May you be made strong in our weakness, O God, that the enemy will not feed in our weakness. In the name of Jesus, and destroy us, O God. Because Your word saith, and we know that the enemy comes not but to come, steal, and destroy. But You came that we will have life more abundantly. We thank You for Your coming, O Jesus. We pray for Your strength, Your directions, O God. Have Your own way in our lives, O God. Lead us, O God. Direct us, O God. We have no strength of ours, O God. Without You, we are nothing, O God. We pray for wisdom, O God, understanding, insight, O God, into Your word. I pray and I commit our student in this house in Your hands, O God. May You open our minds and understanding in the name of Jesus. Those who are yet graduating from high school, oh God, we pray in the name of Jesus. You said we have been given the power to trample upon scorpions and snakes. Therefore, we pray, oh God, wherever we ask, we believe we receive. And Your word said, whatever is bind on earth is bind in the heavens. And the Bible said, if we ask, we receive. If we knock, the door will be open. And if we seek, we shall find. Tonight, we pray. We pray for the anointing of all. Oh God, scholarship upon all graduating students this year in the name of Jesus. We pray for heavenly healing, oh God. Your word said, by Your stripes all diseases are healed. We pray that anything, any weakness in our mortal bodies, we pray for Your healing in the name of Jesus. Upon Mount Zion, there is deliverance. We pray for deliverance, O God. May You deliver us from all afflictions in the name of Jesus. things that we do not want to do that we do. We pray that you help us, oh God. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, everlasting Father. In the name of Jesus. Amen.